Hello students, this is video number 52 and in this video we will study different examples of electrolysis. Students, this topic is very important from board point of view. Now first let's discuss what type of question it comes in the paper. Like name the electrolyte used, name the electrode used, write the reaction at cathode and anode. What is the overall reaction? Name the metal which is deposited at cathode and what is its color. Name the non-metal which is deposited at anode and what is the color of the gas. So let's discuss each and every aspect of these examples in detail. So first example which is there in your syllabus is electrolysis of molten lead bromide. As I told you in the previous video, molten state means whenever an electrolyte, that is ionic compound, it is heated, it is fused and it is converted into molten state. That is why it is known as molten lead bromide. In case of lead bromide, when it is heated above 380 degrees Celsius, which is the melting point of lead bromide, then we can pass electric current in the molten state and lead bromide becomes good conductor of electricity as the force of attraction, electrostatic force of attraction between lead and bromine, it becomes weak. Now, electrolytic cell is made up of silica. It is a crucible which is made up of silica. Electrodes, both cathode and anode, they are made up of graphite. Ions present in the electrolyte are Pb plus 2 and Br negative. Now let's first discuss the diagram. Diagram is given in figure 6.4 of your book. This is a crucible which is made up of silica. Two electrodes, that is cathode and anode, are immersed in the electrolyte in a crucible. Cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Both cathode and anode are made up of graphite. First dissociation reaction. PbBr2 dissociate to give us Pb plus 2 and Br negative. Pb plus 2 being a positively charged ion, it moves towards the cathode where reduction takes place. Pb plus 2 will gain 2 electrons and it changes into neutral lead and the color of lead is silver gray. Same way, Br negative is an anion. Being a negatively charged, it will move towards anode. And the discharge of anion takes place. Discharge means the negatively charged ion is converted into a neutral atom or a gas. Br negative will lose one electron and will change into Br. Br being unstable, two atoms of Br, they combine and form a reddish brown gas, that is bromine. So overall reaction we may write PbBr2 gives us Pb plus Br2. Now there is one note over here. As I told you before, silica is non-reactive. That is why the crucible is made up of silica. There are mainly two reasons to use silica. Number one, it can withstand very high temperature. That is, it will not break whether the temperature is high or low. Second reason is it is almost a non-conductor of electricity. That is, it does not conduct electric current. Then second is graphite anode is preferred to other electrodes such as platinum, as graphite is unaffected by bromine vapors. It does not react with bromine vapors. Then third thing I told you, that solid lead bromide is not used as an electrolyte as it does not give free ions. Only in the molten form when dissolved or when fused, it gives free ions which are responsible for the flow of current and it behaves as a good conductor of electricity. Now, second example which we have to study is electrolysis of acidified water using platinum as electrode. Now, electrolyte used in this example is acidified water. Acidified water means water plus dilute sulfuric acid. As you know, students, pure water is a bad conductor of electricity. It does not conduct current. So, a little amount of sulfuric acid is added to water, and sulfuric acid behaves as a catalyst and increases the conductivity of water. Electrodes are made up of platinum, that is inert electrodes. Ionization reaction. Water, it dissociates to give us H positive and OH negative. As along with water, sulfuric acid is also present, that will also dissociate to give us H positive and SO4 minus 2. Now, ions present in the electrolyte are H positive, OH negative, SO4 minus 2. And particles present are H positive, OH negative, SO4 minus 2 and water. Now, reaction at cathode. Now, H positive is a cation present in the electrolyte. Being positively charged, it will move towards cathode, and at cathode, it will gain one electron and form H. Two atoms of H combines and forms H2, that is hydrogen gas. Now, out of OH negative and SO4 minus 2, OH negative is present lower in the electrochemical series, as we have done in the previous video. The one which is lower in the electrochemical series will be discharged first. So, OH negative will be discharged first. It will lose electron and will form OH. OH being unstable, the two atoms of OH, they combine and form water plus nascent oxygen. So, two nascent oxygen atoms combines to give us O2. So, O2 gas is released at anode and hydrogen gas is released at cathode. Now, come to the diagram. This is the diagram or apparatus used for the electrolysis of acidified water. There are two limbs, one for the collection of hydrogen and other for the collection of oxygen gas. In between, there is a bulb through which we pass or pour acidified water, that is water plus dilute sulfuric acid. Cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. So, hydrogen ions will move towards H positive will move towards cathode, OH negative towards anode. Therefore, hydrogen gas is collected or deposited at cathode and oxygen gas at anode. Now, student, here there is one important question related to electrolysis of acidified water, that in the electrolysis of acidified water, ratio of hydrogen to oxygen is 2:1. As you know only, in H2O, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of oxygen to give us water. This simply depends upon the balancing of the equation only. Now, let's see how. If you see these equations, 4OH, because OH and OH is unstable. So, you balance this equation. After balancing, what happens? We write 2OH combines with 2OH to give us 2H2O, 2 to 4, 2 plus 2, 4 and 2O. 1O plus 1O give us O2. Now, 2 plus 2OH, 4OH. So, we will write here 4OH. So, 4OH negative will lose 4 electrons to give us 4OH. So, these electrons we have to balance with hydrogen also. So, 4H positive will gain 4 electron to give us 4H. 2H plus 2H to give us 1 atom of oxygen. 2 plus 2, 4 to 2 hydrogen atom. So, we may see from this equation that water on dissociation gave us hydrogen plus O2, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. That is why the ratio is 2:1.